On this week's episode, we use a helicopter to go snowboarding and we take some pictures of it. 3, 2, 1. I'm Taylor Jackson. I travel and I take pictures. It's always been my dream to have a travel show, so one day I just woke up and did it. Turns out that if you're booking a heli trip on 12 hours notice and they still have space, you can get a pretty wicked deal. Honestly, on the flight to our first drop, I was super nervous. I almost called to cancel an hour after I signed up because I thought that we were going to be doing some crazy 40 degree pitches all day. I almost psyched myself out of one of the best experiences of my life. I'm from the East Coast, where we're used to riding ice and hard pack. So riding in a little bit of snow actually took some getting used to. This is the moment that I realized that not having my professional camera and lenses in my backpack was probably a good idea. With me today, I have a Nikon D5500 and the kit lens. The entire camera setup cost me less than $600 on Kijiji. Photographically, heli skiing is where it's at. You get to ride down a mountain, then go on a sightseeing flight, and ride, and flight. It's really amazing. That said, if you're primarily in this to ski or snowboard, I actually recommend that you go cat skiing. It's way less expensive, you get the same vertical, and you're pretty much guaranteed to get out regardless of the weather. You just don't get to feel as much like James Bond unloading out of a helicopter on the top of a mountain. Today we were lucky and got some great weather. No knee-deep powder, unfortunately, but we got some great spring snow.
Dad, we went heli skiing today in the Coast Mountains, British Columbia. It was a lovely springtime day. And it's beautiful. We're about 80 kilometers from the ocean right now, and we're sitting up at a mountain peak at plus 12 degrees Celsius. So we skied some nice schmoo badgen, I call it, like a schmoo badger. There's a crust badger, there's a honey badger, and then there's a schmoo badger. And that's what we did today. We did some schmoo badgen, rode some waves, and had a good time. Thank you.
All right, I'm on my way up the Whistler gondola. It is 6:30 in the morning. Very weird to be one, alone on a gondola, and two, that everything outside, it's still nighttime. Fresh Shocks is one of the only tourist excursions in the world, 100% worth doing. Basically what you do is you get to go up and have a buffet breakfast at the top of the mountain, and then as soon as the ski patrol open the line at the bottom and they start uploading the gondola, you get to go down. So you get to be one of the only 650 people, which seems like a lot, but when you spread it out over an entire mountain, it's not that much, so.
People line up as early as 5:45 on powder days to get up here and hit the fresh snow. Well, look at the view here and look at where we are. It's quite the amazing place to be and to live and to work and to play.
Tanto que hacer. Hay tanto que hacer. Me siento bien, no hay tiempo que perder. Tanto que ver, hay tanto que ver. ¿Cuál será mi hazaña al abrir mis pestañas?
Clearly today is not a powder day, but imagine if it were a powder day and you had this place all to yourself. I think that is a ride worth coming all the way here for.
Si pensando en ti, río en tus aguas, me quiero sumergir. Desde hoy no me voy a arrepentir. Desde hoy no me voy a arrepentir.
When I was 17, I actually made my first travel video here in Whistler. My only bucket list item at the time was to ride on the West Coast. My buddy Scott and I pooled all of our money to make it happen, and I made my first travel film on a 2-megapixel Olympus point and shoot. That was the camera that started my career in photography and filmmaking. Thanks for the amazing time, Whistler and area. You are my first travel love, and it is so good to be back. On next week's episode, we go underwater and chase sea turtles in Hawaii.